dignitaries, and distinguished guests, colleagues, participants, it is my pleasure to give this closing remarks. I hope it works. Sorry. So my my presentation will cover the outcomes of this international year of basic sciences for sustainable development with regard to the upcoming international decade of all sciences and all knowledge, including traditional and indigenous, for sustainable development. Both the international year and the international decade were proclaimed by the United Nations General Assemblies and are under the auspices of UNESCO, which I want to thank a lot. So I will start with the outcomes of the International Year of Basic Sciences for Sustainable Development. So as it was mentioned many times, it was proclaimed by the United General Assembly on December 2nd, 2021, under the auspices of UNESCO, and the resolutions was brought up by the Republic of Honduras with the active support of 35 countries and adopted by consensus. So the rationale behind this international year was explained, and at the end of my presentation, I will show you a short video on that. So basically, curiosity-driven sciences construct the pool of knowledge which future generations will use for their developments. Basic sciences are not always recognized as they deserve. Curiosity-driven sciences re-enchant our world and make it worth to be sustainable. Serendipity plays a role. You have to be lucky. By the way, I am very happy that in Spain there was a lottery ticket with the logo of IYBSSD, as you can see, which illustrates a little bit of this serendipity. Basic sciences explore the soul of the universe. So a few examples, which were also evoked today and yesterday. Vaccines and treatments against COVID-19 are full of basic sciences. The web was born at CERN from the needs of collaboration. It was totally serendipitous and made free to the planet due to the policy of open science at CERN. Web research engines are full of brilliant mathematical ideas. The GPS relies on atomic clocks and on quantum mechanics. Gene therapies relies on basic biology. Generation and storage of renewable energy will depend on physics and chemistry. The second quantum revolution, which is very abstract, we are almost sure will have very important applications. And there are many other examples, like artificial intelligence, which relies on statistical methods. Cellular phones are full of transistors and of quantum mechanics again. PET scan and MRI are based on antimatter imaging at CERN. Reduction in pollution and green chemistry rely on basic advances in chemistry. So as it was mentioned, the International Year of Basic Sciences for Sustainable Development was organized thanks to a steering committee with 53 partners, you can see them. IUPAP was serving as the legal entity, the International Union of Pure and Applied Physics. We got the support of many academies, 132 academies, networks, and associations. We got also the patronage of 30 Nobel laureates and field medalists. These unions, organizations, academies, and networks, and associations are the foundations for the success of the year and for further initiatives beyond this international year, like the decade, for instance. It is a real asset. We had strong collaboration, obviously, with UNESCO, since we are under the auspices of UNESCO. but also with the International Science Council, which was part of the steering committee, the World Science Forum, the Club of Rome was a strong supporter, active supporter, also the Inter-Parliamentary Union. In the short video that you saw before, it was mentioned that many events occurred, almost 500 events, in more than 70 countries. The flagship events were the opening ceremony in UNESCO in Paris, the Science, Ethics, and Human Development in Quy Nhon, Vietnam, the World Conference of Basic Sciences and Sustainable Development in Belgrade, the African Continental Conference on Basic Sciences for Transformation in Kigali, Rwanda, the Fundamental Life Science Meets Climate, Environment, and Sustainability in Paris, France, and the closing ceremony today at CERN. So the outcomes of this, of some of these flagship events. The statement of the opening ceremony was the following: basic sciences are curiosity and inquiry driven. They are the foundations of education and the sources of discoveries, which turn into applications. They can then serve an inclusive, sustainable development, improving global equity and well-being together with a healthy and lively planet. All together, education, discoveries, applications, and inclusive, sustainable development can boost collaborative and open basic sciences. This is the virtuous circle that we want to promote during the International Year of Basic Sciences for Sustainable Development, and after, but by after, we had already in mind the international decade. To achieve this goal, we shall need you, teachers, scientists, entrepreneurs, and society at large, to share this vision and act accordingly. A decade of sciences for sustainability might be necessary. This was already in the air at this stage. So the event in Vietnam, Quy Nhon, Science, Ethics, and Human Development, in the International Center for Interdisciplinary Science and Education. The director is Jean Trantan Van, here in the room and here in the picture. Scientific knowledge, technology, and innovation shape our lives, our imaginations, our hopes, our fears. It is a common universal heritage. However, for scientists, business as usual is no more an option. Every scientist through his or her institution, especially when supported by public funds, and even if his research is curiosity and inquiry driven, must try to best connect to the society and should have in mind how his or her activity and findings could impact the world. So this is responsibility and might be of interest for contributing to make it better and not worse. However, scientists must be given the necessary funding and freedom. This is a counterpart of responsibility, and the right to collaborate with the other scientists in their field to conduct their research, science for peace, with this kind of freedom, and be listened to all at all levels of decision making, and inspire that way the decision makers and the society at large. It is a balancing act, so responsibility and freedom, to ensure societies trust their scientists and the knowledge they provide. Doctoral education should include in priority ethics, integrity, and sustainability. The American Physical Society, together with other national physical societies, with the support of the International Union of Pure and Applied Physics, issued a research policy statement, which was mentioned yesterday by Jonathan Bagger in the Open Science Side session with UNESCO. You can find the QR code in the presentation of Jonathan Bagger, giving you the full statement. So the statement is based on insisting on integrity, transparency, open sciences respecting intellectual property, reciprocity between scientists and institutions. This is establishing trust. In this statement, there is a call upon the governments and those who promote policies and practices that advance international scientific collaborations to, first, enact travel and visa policies that enable scientific interactions between peers and partners. And this is a critical issue in this time where we have more and more dividing walls. assess policies to ensure that they do not result in unnecessary or unintended barriers to multinational research collaborations, and foster new opportunities for international research collaboration and exchanges for early career physicists. A plea for basic and applied sustainability science. So this was already establishing the core of the international decade. Multidisciplinary and integrative education should be implemented in addition to the standard STEM education. Sustainability sciences must be co-constructed, this was said in the previous panel. Scientists with private and public sectors should work together, co-constructed, and solution-oriented and impact-oriented, not especially publishing-oriented, and should be open, so open publishing, open data, open software, open hardware, open innovation, open to citizens. It goes, this sustainability sciences, goes from a very basic understanding the planet habitability to the 17 interconnected SDGs and beyond. It is an interplay between curiosity-driven science, applied sciences, and traditional knowledge. So again, reduce poverty, improve well-being, you heard that from the Club of Rome, beyond just consuming, target global equity for a lively and healthy planet. So what could be the application target of this sustainability sciences? It is to mimic nature, so to have a circular economy fueled by decarbonated energy. Nature succeeds to do that. So we should do that, continue in this spirit. This could be the application target with a lot of innovations and new practices needed. It could benefit for their organization for sustainability sciences from models of organizations in big basic sciences like CERN, and from the IPCC and IPBES model of interaction between scientists and decision makers. Again, this underlines the necessity for a decade of action for sustainability. And with this, we went to the United States Nations General Assembly, and thanks to His Excellency Csaba Corosi, we succeeded to have a session dedicated to the sciences for sustainable development, and thanks to Serbia, we got the resolution which was submitted to the General Assembly and proclaimed by consensus with 58 supporting countries, but it was adopted by consensus. So you will not be surprised that the rationale and goals were already prepared and evoked during the international year. Basic sciences, although essential for sustainability, are not enough. We need to embark all sciences, basic, applied, social, and humanities, even arts, and all knowledge systems, including traditional and indigenous. Equitable, peaceful, and planet-friendly circular economy fueled by decarbonated energy should be the application target of these sustainability sciences, with a lot of innovations and new practices needed. Sciences for sustainability are already rising, but they are very fragmented, thematically, geographically, and also from the point of view of the organization. We need to educate, to mobilize what we call transdisciplinary sustainability hubs. So this means scientists together with the society, maybe with NGOs, well-selected NGOs, with private sector, with the public sector, even with politicians, together to co-transform efficiently. And we need a kind of spider web organization going from villages, so hubs in villages, hubs in regions, hubs in nations, hubs in continents, and a global, maybe a global international organization to orchestrate all that. This idea of connecting science to the society and to politicians was already in the Club of Rome, which was mentioned before. The Club of Rome consists of scientists, politicians, economists, also social scientists, humanities, arts also, and NGOs. So we need thousands of mini club of Rome in villages, in regions, in nations, in continents, and globally speaking, to work on where are we going, to work on the data, to integrate the data, and to define pathways, roadmaps at all levels of scales. So, as it was mentioned many times, we need global challenge. So these global challenges are all interconnected. So we need to work from components to system approach, from local to global, from short term to long term, involving open science and the society at large. They are threatening in some sense, but they are a unique opportunity to cooperate and build a better world. So following further the international mobilization that we hope with the decade, laws and treaties should be enacted towards these goals based on a dialogue between all stakeholders, including scientists. So in these difficult times where we see more and more conflicts and raising walls, we have still to be optimistic, and I count on you for that, and yes, we can, but more important also, yes, we must. Thank you. Thank you very much. So before I start now the thanking ceremony, as I promised you, I want to show you a short video made by CERN. It's a 1 minute video made by CERN at the very beginning of the International Year, which I showed everywhere in the world. Many times we can say that it is the video of the International Year. Starring in it, my grandniece, Eloise Goldberg, 13 years old, now 14. So, enjoy.
Curiosity about the world around us is what makes us human. This desire to make sense of the world is the driving force behind fundamental science. Stirred by this curiosity, each new generation of scientists adds to the pool of knowledge built up by previous generations. We are at a crucial time for the future of our planet. Now, more than ever, it is imperative to use this pool of knowledge to help solve the global problems we face and pave the way for a more sustainable development. And we must not stop being curious. Future generations will be inspired by the knowledge we contribute today, equipping them with the powerful tools they need to build a better world.
So for the first time, I want to ask Eloise, she's in the room, to come on stage. She is the muse of the year, so I ask her to come on stage. By the way, she wants to become the first woman Formula One pilot. And she's working hard on that. So you stay on stage, I will call other people also. I want to thank the steering committee, as this was mentioned many times, the steering committee, the 53 partners, and I think we have to applaud them strongly. They were the partners of the year. I want to thank the executive committee, which acted very strongly to make this International Year a success. So Luc Allemand, he will come on the stage later on, Secretary General. Bruce McKellar, Treasurer. Lily Rodriguez, Vice Chair from Peru. Prajwal Shastri from India, Vice Chair also. Marianne Kansa, she was here today from Ghana. Jean-Trentin Van, who is in the room from Vietnam. Maurizio Bona from CERN, who was decisive for the decade. Laura McConnell, chemist from USA. Miriam Chadid from Morocco. And Amal Kasri, I think she's still in the room. Yes, she's there. Okay, so we thank them and we applaud them. So I want also that we upload all the speakers of today. I think we had a very nice day meeting with very, very good speakers, from young to older people, but a nice mixture and very enthusiastic. I think they deserve a good applause. I ask now those who were behind the scene, the students from the International Association from Physics, students, the International Association of Physics students. So they helped to pass the microphone, and they helped also for the cloakroom, and also our colleagues from the CERN and Society Foundation, who helped all along the ceremony. Can you come on stage? Please. Come. I invite also Jens Wiegen and Lauren Massarotti from CERN, who were instrumental for the success of this ceremony, to come on stage. And I want to thank CERN, the CERN Reggie behind you, who did follow all that, and also the CERN management for hosting so well this event. So it's like at the opera. I call now Luc Allemand, the Secretary General of the International Year, who did all the work. Congratulations. Who did all the work for today and for the International Year. Thank you, Luc. Really, thank you very much. And we will now listen. So this is a surprise for the last slide. We will now listen to the Blue Planet anthem, especially composed for IYBSSD. So this is the anthem of the year, composed by Constantin Rusnak from Moldova. Here are the. If everything works well, I welcome online the President of the Moldova Parliament and the deputies of the Moldova Parliament, who will listen to this anthem. Yeah.